in recent memory?
Mariah Carey. Oh, Mariah. She, you know, she's a great songwriter, I will
say that. And, you know, Vision of Love, whenever she broke out on the scene with that song, I, you know, just became an instant fan.
It's very hard for me to sing, so it's one of the most personal songs on this record. It's called Oh Mother. You know, I grew up with a lot of abuse in my household whenever I was a very young girl, up until, you know, the ages of 7 or 8 when my mom left my father, and this is sort of my thank you song to my mom. Oh my God, I'm getting a tear. for getting us out of the situation, because it's you know, so hard to do. I'm sorry, this is the first time that I'm singing this material, so it's... Well, I'm never gonna get through it like this, huh?
Came the rain and washed the spider out. Out came the sun and dried up all the rain. And the itsy bitsy spider left his mouth again. Oh, star, how I wonder what you are. Up above the world so high, like a diamond in the sky.
All right, that's...
I grew up not really having sort of any sort of real male perspective or role model, and Jordan just continuously just makes me fall deeper and deeper in love with
him. Hi. Can I come in?
He just exudes such love and such a great father to Max that it just makes me the happiest woman alive. And I'm lucky to have him in my life.
I remember crying, and we turn on the TV, and it was the Grammy Awards. The show starts with Christina Aguilera singing the song Beautiful.
I am beautiful, no matter what they say.
When you talk about time, and no matter what people say, no matter what people do, you're beautiful.
We decided, like, he's going to be beautiful.
And then we got up out of the bed, and we went down to the NICU, and we held Nathaniel for the first time. We held our son, and it was awesome. And
a number on a chart, or an award, or recognition, it's speaking your truth, and speaking from your heart, and living as loud and as best we can in our own situation. We're the same person, we're just given different circumstances.
Family, I have somebody I want you to meet.
Christina Aguilera.
Hi, guys.
Well, actually, Christina has one more surprise for you.
I've had a lot of great successes, and I've been fortunate enough to, you know, win a few Grammys and all the things that she's mentioned, but from my heart, it really means a lot to be recognized for what's most important to me, and that truly is to connect with people. Level and use my voice to try and help inspire others to then use theirs. And something that I've learned through experiences that I've had with the World Food Program, and Jonathan Blum, you're just so amazing. I just realized we're all the same person.
Trip to Guatemala.
What
was that all about?
I'm becoming a UN ambassador for World Hunger with the WFP World Food Program. Taking a trip. Thank you. I'll be taking a trip to Haiti this week.
to check out the situation there and assess. We just helped deliver food. I visit orphanages and the schools there and try to do my part in helping this.
And doesn't that just change your whole perspective on your own life? You know, you wake up in the morning and you've been able to experience other worlds like
tremendously.
That.
A child dies every 6 seconds of hunger, which was a huge statistic for me, and one that I you know, after having my own child, I was like, I have to be a part of this and do my part some way in giving and helping the situation, helping the world.
I had read this.
And we're all one. No one's any better than anybody else. Everyone is the same person. We're all connected. You know, through my travels to Guatemala, to Haiti, to Rwanda, where I'm so touched and so inspired by so many experiences. I just realized, you know, it's not about, yes, the stage is a platform for me, and I'm able to see these kids with goals and dreams of their own, and it's a really, really beautiful thing to witness and to see that, God, all it takes is a meal just to provide them with the opportunity to achieve their goals. It all starts with just proper nutrition, and it inspires them to grow and to learn and to achieve whatever they can dream of. Because I wanted to keep it very real and organic, and I wanted to feel every emotion inside of it to do it for you here today. And I did rehearse it once, and it was really hard to get through. It's about my childhood. I've spoken very openly about growing up in a household where there was a lot of abuse and it was a lot of domestic violence, and you know, seeing what my mom went through, what I went through as a child, you know, not feeling like I had a safe place to go home to. And that can stick with you for many, many years past just the moment. And the positive about this is that it's taking the sad and the ugly and the past and the pain and all of that. I don't know if I would really be sitting up here in front of you if it wasn't for all that I endured growing up with that kind of a past, because it made me so determined that I would not back down for anybody. I would never feel helpless to a man. I would make for myself, I would do for myself, and nothing was going to stop me or get in my way. And, you know,
together we can end world hunger. Donate at these participating restaurants today.
Thank you guys so much.
We love you!
I love you, Christina!
Tonight's journey with me and venturing back. For a long time, I've missed this so much. I could cry right now.
I just really hope my outfit
But, you know, being a mom is really important to me, and I'm a very, you know, hands-on mom. That's what makes us greater and better people and builds our character and makes us stronger. But, you know, I just wanted to have a great safe haven for my kids, and so I didn't want to let them ever feel like they were abandoned. But mama needs to get back to what I was meant to do. And I can't let them abandon you guys either, so thank you so much for being here tonight. It really means the world to me. The first night out, so sorry for any extra. Thank you very much. I think many of us struggle sometimes with, you know, the lightness and the darkness and, you know, that we feel sometimes, and also the struggle between balancing and juggling our lives. This next song is touches on that. So if you know the words to this song, go ahead and sing along with me. This song is called Twice.
To see these children with smiles on their faces and, you know, asking for seconds and just like, you know, normal children being able to have these opportunities. And, you know, the funny thing is, you know, food is, it should never be a luxury.
I love you too. Ride with me tonight. It's been so fun with you. I've always been a message girl. I can't make music without saying something, so thank you guys so much for always being fighters with me and always standing up for what you guys believe in too. It means a lot to me that you guys have voices too and that you guys stand up for what you guys believe in. I love your stories. I love who you guys and what you guys stand for too. Yes. I miss Demi on that one too. I hope she's doing good. She's great, 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 great woman. I really love her. Oh, so yes, I have not toured for a while. So sorry for the delay, but yeah, I mean, exactly. Bitch, let's just go do this already. but no, I mean, yeah, I mean, it takes a toll when you have families and all that. Like, it takes, you know, it's a juggling act. It's definitely balancing, but it's exactly what it is, though. It kind of is like, okay, well, gotta get back out and do what you were created to do already, and you know, you feel like you've left something or the other, but you know. When you're born to do something, you're just meant to do it, so, okay. Yeah, bitch. Let's do it. So I can also show my kids, too, you know, this is what mommy does. This is what working hard, you know, means. And, you know, great things don't just grow on trees. You gotta work for them. And, you know, I want to instill in them a good work ethic as well. Show them that. So thank you guys for coming, supporting, and being there with me too along the way. It means a lot to me.
And speaking of just that, and juggling and balancing different worlds and all of that, it's very hard too, you know, going through and coming through a past, as some of you know who struggle with your own, you know, to quiet the voices sometimes and just figure it out and, you know, be emotionally and just ready and strong to face anything, especially in the public eye. So, you know, but again, you know, I was meant to do it. And so sometimes when you're struggling, it's like, you know, there's so many questions and there's so many things you need answered, and sometimes you're fighting against your light side and your dark side and you don't know which one to listen to. So in the end, though, we just have to give in to, we're all made up of all of that, and it's good and it's bad and it's great, because both things equal who you are as a person, the individual side of you. Is you at the end of the day, and you know, you overcome those rough moments and those rough patches, and you just become that much more beautiful at the end. So this next song, though, is about the struggle and the forgiveness of that at the end of the day. And then there came a time where, as grateful as I was for getting my foot in the door, I had to put some real honesty and truth behind what I was doing and come from a place of my own stories and my own struggles, and hopefully inspire others to share their stories. And I wrote an album called Stripped.
Faces and think, oh, these are my people, you know, this is where I'm from.
I got to see a little bit of the video from your trip and the interaction that you had with the kids. You even got to sing to the kids a little bit.
I did.
El pollito dice.
Los pollitos dicen. Yeah, I would. Domestic violence is a very near and dear, very real, true cause for me. I've been very vocal and open, I think my whole career pretty much, about my own experiences and witnessing domestic violence in my own home and in surrounding homes in my neighborhood where I grew up, all over the country and everywhere. My dad was in the army, but yeah, I've experienced a lot on many different levels, and so that's why it's so important for me to be partnering with Verizon in helping spread awareness with their relationship with Hopeline, and allowing everyone the opportunity to go ahead and help support the cause as well. It affects everybody more than you know, and probably a lot more people in your life than.
I was thrilled when I got the opportunity to come aboard and do a voiceover for Hello World. My episode is all about being a mama and what it takes to be a protector and a warrior and a nurturer of your little ones. And it couldn't be more perfect for me to be talking about. I always reference myself as a mama bear.
This is so important. I was approached by Yum Brands, who partners with the World Food Program in the UN to help provide food and nutrition as meals.
Aguilera has served as food ambassador.
Hey everyone, I'm challenging you to pass the red cup for World Hunger Relief. Donate $5 and help feed 20 children. Pass it on.
I'm just thankful that there are aid organizations and people with beautiful hearts in the WFP and so on that are helping to provide these children with opportunities and nutrition.
And now Ecuador.
It gets emotional for me because it is really, really hard to see some of their situations. I love going on these trips and going into the fields and meeting these people that have these incredible stories and of survival and of struggle.